Coming up on Shalom TV, we look back at the past 6 months.
Check out some of the highlights of the Year 12 formal.
Keep you up to date with our principal, Mr. Dan McMahon.
And look at what's coming up over the next two terms.
Hello, I'm Chelsea Costa.
And I'm Ben Mallows. Welcome to a new season of Shalom TV.
We start the program with Principal Talk with our principal, Mr. Dan McMahon.
And welcome back to Shalom TV. We're more than halfway through the year. We really wonder, where is that 6 months gone? There's been so much happening. Term one, term two were so full of so many activities and great student learning. This week, we've just sent out 270 acceptances for enrolments for year seven for 2022, which is just fantastic. So there'll be a lot of happy young people and families out there, but also, regrettably, quite a number of disappointed families who we just couldn't fit in to Shalom next year. It's great that Shalom is a school of choice for so many families. And talking to them has been a great privilege, talking to parents and students as they look to come to Shalom next year. I often talk to parents about the best thing about Shalom that I think of us as a college is the culture we have here. And that's, how do we do things around here? What are the things we value? What are the things we don't value? And I think that culture at Shalom is really positive. And that is attracting so many people, so many families who want to come to this school. As part of that culture, I wrote to parents and spoke to students a couple of times on assembly about a quite strong stance we're taking around respectful relationships. That issue of inappropriate images on the internet and the consequences for students around that is really important to us to build a strong culture here. But students need to be here and know they are respected 24/7, 365 days a year. So that's something that we'll continue to emphasise with our young people and really hope and pray that we always have the support of parents with that. In a similar way, last week we celebrated our NAIDOC week assembly, which was beautifully done and a great tribute to the Aboriginal Torres Strait Islander students and families and the staff at Shalom. I took the opportunity again to remind young people about how important it is that we respect everyone in this community and that all those issues that we see in society and we see round about us of racism are just simply unacceptable at Shalom. And for those to be dealt with, I need people to let us know when that happens. We need to beat that culture where people sort of say, if I raise an issue, it'll make it worse. It won't make it worse. In fact, it will make it better. We need to challenge those attitudes and values that are inappropriate, that are against our culture here at Shalom. Last semester, towards the end of term, we had so many great things happening. We had our National School Improvement Audit, which again affirmed what a great school Shalom is, and it gave us things that we can work on for the next 5 years, but certainly affirmed the journey we've been on, and certainly strongly affirmed the culture that's at the college. It was unfortunate that both the quiz rule and the quiz and carnals were cut short by COVID, but the young people who participated in those just did an outstanding job, and it was great to be part of that with them, and at least they had two wonderful days of competition. Big shout out also to the sports department and Mr. Gills and his team who revamped our athletics days in the last 2 days of last term to make them much more engaging for young people and so much more involved. So they were two really good days. Thank you to all those who participated. So thanks for all that's gone on in the first 6 months of this year, and the next 6 months undoubtedly will be just as busy. Thank you to you, the families of Shalom students who help build this culture every day by your support and your participation. Thank you so much, but don't take it for granted.
It's been a strange but busy time over the past two terms, so we thought we'd take a look back at some of the highlights.
You're welcome as we gather here with our Year 12s.
You will want them to enjoy a healthy and life-giving planet, and we need leaders of vision and initiative to ensure that occurs.
About 49% of Australians were born overseas or have at least 1%, one parent who was. We identify with over 300 ancestries.
To find out more about what's coming up on the sports calendar for this term.
Welcome to Shalom Sport. Term 3 is obviously a massive term for sporting events and some of the sporting events coming up in the next few weeks. 5 teams will visit to the Sunshine Coast, hopefully COVID-free. To compete in the Queensland All Schools Oztag Championships starting next Friday. Bunny District, that track and field, is following in week 4 with usually a team of about 140 students competing for Shalom and vying for district selection to then go to the Wide Bay Trials later in the term. Our rugby league teams, Aaron Payne Cup and Cowboys Challenge, continue to play some games in those competitions over the next few weeks with some crossovers. Our Vicky Wilson netball teams, Open Boys and Open Girls, head down to the state finals in week 4. So we wish them the best of luck. Our Shalom Open T20 cricket side plays the Southern Conference finals against Matthew Flinders, hopefully in the middle of August. So looking forward to that trip. The Shalom Open Girls rugby league team compete in the Karen Murphy Cup. So we wish them all the best. The big event that Shalom's hosting is the Wide Bay All Schools Touch Football Carnival on the 2nd of September. Schools from all over Wide Bay will come to Bundaberg to compete in that. And finally, Winter Sports starts next Wednesday for 6 weeks with several Shalom teams involved in sports such as netball, basketball, football, table tennis and timpani bowling. And of course, the biggest sporting event of the year obviously is the Olympics starting this weekend. Come on the Aussies.
Because we look back over the year so far, we thought we'd take the opportunity to look at the events to look forward to in Term 3.
I've done real life, well, through Shalom for a few years now, like going with my friends, you know, it was like, it's a great organisation, and it's just an amazing event. Like, I would have so much fun and we'd be exhausted with my friends. I've got so many photos and videos of us just looking like zombies, but having like so many memories. And then having the opportunity to be the face of Real Life for Life is so weird because you like go to the Real Life and you see the face go up there and you're like, oh, that poor person. And then I'm like, that's me. So I guess it's cool to be able to like share my story and tell people like, don't like stress about when will I get sick, will I get sick, you know. If it happens, it happens. Like, you can't control everything. I guess it's just pretty cool to be face of Relay for Life this year.
The Bundaberg Relay for Life committee would like to thank Shalom College for their generosity and hard work in helping us bring this live stream to you. When we first thought of the idea and we contacted Shalom, unhesitatingly they said yes, and we just couldn't be more pleased with what they've done and how helpful they've been, and of course their expertise.
To the bright side of the road. All right, here we go.
Throw you in the fire. Paint the air, paint the sky. Paint the love in your life. Throw the colors and watch them light up the world.
And nothing but city.
Thank you.
So, as you all know, we're here for the Bundaberg Virtual Relay for Life. It's been a fantastic event so far, and we hope everyone who's out there relaying, all the teams that are relaying, are having a great time as well, whatever you're doing.
Thought we'd leave you with the new overview video of Shalom College. Enjoy. And we'll see you next time on Shalom TV. Bye! Thank you.